acting like a little kid. You know, he's growing into a man now, so all that stuff changes. You know, it's going to make him more confident, and that's what I think he tried to say. He's getting to be more confident about what he is and what he wants to do, and that's because he's growing. He's becoming a man, you know, and he's learning things. You know, he's learning that life is not what you think it is. You know, not life. Life is not, you know, flowers and everything. You know, you got a lot of bad things out there, and a lot of bad people could hurt you. You got to be very careful. Man, I don't think so. I think this guy's scared of us. I have very called him in numerous of times. He just comes out laughing, saying that my son got unfinished business at the 135 weight division. The last time I heard, my son is fighting for undisputed, and this fight is going to be announced as undisputed. Everybody knows he's undisputed. You know, everybody else has regular belts. You know, Mauricio Suleiman said my son has a prestigious belt at the 135 weight division. Okay, so Tank and everybody else, and I don't know how many fanboys over here that support Tank or Devin Haney, they don't got no real belts. You know, because the last time I checked, the WBA, which he's fighting for Rolando Romero, is my son's. You know what I'm saying? And that's, you know, and they're calling it a world title. You know, that's not a world title. Even Rolando Romero said that my son is number one at 135.
What do you think in the press conference. What do you think of Rolando, you know, losing out on that fight and replacement?
I think it's unfair. I think that, and we're living in a country where we have rights, and I don't think somebody should be guilty without being found guilty. I think there's a process to it, and that's what makes us free. It makes us a different nation. It makes us different from everybody else. I don't think they gave him that opportunity. I think this was this was foul, and I don't know who's in it, but a lot of people are in it. You know what I'm saying? Because he was a big risk for Rolando Romero. I think I was gonna be in his corner as well, and I don't get to live that moment to see this guy knocked out. You know, Tank gets hit all the time. You know what I'm saying? And he smothers those shots, you know, to come forward and get confident. He wasn't going to do that with Rolando, trust me, because Rolando could pop, you know, and he was going to be right there in front of his face. So I think that this was foul. I think that they shouldn't do this. You know, I think they should have taken this to court. They should have analyzed it. They should have, you know, had more information about it. And, you know, who the hell is boxing, you know, to tell people you're guilty of something that you don't know if you're guilty of? That's why we have laws. You know, this is bullshit. It's bullshit, you know. Now this guy gets a free ride to fight a dude that nobody knows. You know, he's gonna stop him, bro. Come on, it's just set up for that shit. You know, he should be fighting real dudes like my son, like Josh Taylor. You know, not these bums that he's fighting. You know, and they praising these dudes, bro. They praising him.
How would it go if he fought Haney? Who do you think would win that fight?
Yeah, even Haney, you know, fight those regular dudes, you know, that at least got a belt, you know, that was, even though it was given to Devin, but, you know, at least fight some names that everybody want to see, you know what I'm saying? Because everybody's hyped on these names, but there's only one king, and his name is Teofimo Lopez, bro, and everybody knows that 135, and he's going to be king at 142, you know what I'm saying? Josh Taylor ain't going to be there, bro. We're going to end up fighting somebody for a bacon title, because Josh Taylor's scared of death. My son gonna put him to sleep, and he knows it. That dude comes right there. He's right there in the pocket. And my son don't hit like 140 pounder. My son hit like a 154. You know, so, you know, even when I'm back in the days talking and everybody laughing at me and laughing at me, everything that comes out of my mouth is not because I worship my son. It's because I'm talking the truth. I'm talking the truth. You know, and people don't like truth no more. You know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, we're going to take over this whole boxing shit. And it's coming real soon. You know? That's why my son told you. He's becoming more confident. You know? And if you don't get him now, you're never going to get him. You know, that's why I tell the whole world. You know, the takeover is right here. We're not going nowhere. And I want all you guys to help me. So all these punk-ass dudes come and confront the real fighters. The real guys that want to make it in this world. And that's fighting the champs like it was done back in the days. You know, I know freaking Muhammad Ali must be flipping in his grave seeing this shit. You know, like, oh, I got more followers. What the fuck is that shit? You know, and how do you prove that? How do you prove that? By freaking numbers on a freaking thing? You never know if that's like 50,000, half of those shits are little kids that are not gonna pay when you go to the freaking, you know, to the arenas. Last time I checked with my son, when Terrence Crawford fought and my son was in the card, everybody was standing up and it was a full arena. The main arena in the Madison Square Garden. They were there for my son. You know what I'm saying? And another thing I gotta say, we're fighting at the Hula Theater. But it's not the same as fighting in the Hula Theater when everything was good. We're fighting in the Hula Theater where you gotta get vaccinated, and a lot of people don't believe in that shit.
Right.
You know? So we gotta get fans, boxing fans, that wanna get plugged in and go in to see this fight. So, you know, so you don't put 4,000 people in there. You gotta put 20,000 people in there, because it's not the same shit. You know, in New York, you can't go to an event if you're not vaccinated. And you got to have both vaccinations, you know, or the Johnson, which is only one. So, you know, that makes it hard for people to go in and see a fight. They'd rather stay back and watch TV and let this shit slide until they can't, you know, because a lot of people believe in conspiracies. They don't want to take this, you know, they don't want to take this shit, this shot. So that really messes us up. We gotta see the numbers. And I'm gonna tell Eddie Hearn, give out the real numbers. Cause I'm sick and tired of TMT and all these guys saying that my son don't make no sales. That's crazy. You know, we did 4.2 million on ESPN when we fought Lomachenko. Take 3 million out. 1 million of them are hardcore fans of my son. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I talk the way I talk. And if people don't like it, just, I'm predicting the future. I'm predicting the future, and the last man standing is going to be called Teofimo Lopez, God willing, because all we need is health.
Do you feel that because you feel taken?